Virendra Singh and welcome back at MasterCAM MIL 3D tutorial and toolpaths. MasterCAM, this is our second one exercise and that one over part 3. And in this video we discuss about two of most valuable and using operation for finishing purpose. The number one operation is scale up for the finishing of the entire surface area. And the second one is scale up rest process operation. Scale up rest process operation is basically used for cutting rest material which is stay available after the finishing operation. So both of operation we will discuss with all the parameters. So for creating both of these operation, I have to delete both of these operation. For deleting both of these operation, I select with the control key, right click, and I just delete, and yes. So as you can see, I deleted both of these operation. Now what I have to do? I have to create both of these operation. For creating these operation, we have to go in a mill toolpath, and here at a finish, we have to select scale up operation. Now what is the, when we are clicking on a scale up operation, so that time there is a one window new face will open that is looking like that one. So at here, there are different type of parameters and different things. So what we have to do? The number one first thing is the machining geometry. Machining geometry means ki the area which we have to select, where we have to machining. So for selecting that one area, we click here, and for selecting the entire part, we go at the all select body, select all solid entities, and when we select that one, so entire solid will be selected within a one click. Now we press end selection. So now here there are two options. These options are set so that what will be stock size in the wall and what will be stock size in a floor after this machining. So that one is a finishing operation which we are performing. So we will make both of these zero value. Then next one is tool control. So tool control means ki the area where tool will be cutting, that area we have to select in MasterCAM MIL 3D. For selecting that one area, we have to click here and select this chain. When we are selecting this chain, so that there will be one area. So it means tool will be machining only that one area. And now we press OK. Now we have to select tool. So which one tool we are using? We are using 8 mm ball nose tool. So we can here input what is the feed rate of that one. And we can input here what is finish ball nose. Now what is the next one thing is we have to select holder, stock and cutting parameter. When we are at the cutting parameter, the tool method which we have to select, always make sure when you are using a scale up operation, the mostly time we are using a one way tool method. And then next one is expand inside to outside. It means when we are marked that one, it means tool will be cutting from inside to outside. And when we unmark that one, it means tool will be cutting from outside to inside. And the next one is step over, is 2 or 0.3. So we are making 0.2. Then the next one is transitions, it's 30 degree. Then next step shallow. When we are selecting here detect, it means tool will be automatically detect what is the minimum depth and what is the maximum depth. If we are not selecting here that one geometrical area, so that time tool will be not selected. So that one is also done. Then the next one process which we have to done, that is linking parameters. At linking parameter, when we are clicking here, press OK. So now guys, as you can see here, our toolpath is done. As you can see here, let me show you in a 2D form. So when we are playing that one, as you can see, our toolpath is cutting from outside to inside with a very smooth form. So now what is the issue in this part? That we are cutting that one toolpath, but here what is the that one radius value? Here this radius value is 2.5 as per the drawing. So and we are using that one tool, that is tool 8mm ball nose. For a 8mm ball nose tool, the corner radius is 4 mm. So that still that time there here material is remaining. So for removing that one material, we are using scale up rest material. So let me show you that how we can perform for a scale up rest material. For creating a scale up rest material, we have to select that one operation again, make a copy and paste here. Now we have to select properties, go in a tool control form. At here tool control form, we have to do nothing. And now we have to select tool. Which one tool we want to select? For example, we have to create 2.5 mm of corner radius. So we are selecting a 4 mm ball nose. For a 4 mm ball nose, corner radius is 2.0. So we can input the feed rate, spindle speed and all the necessary things. And now the next one thing is cutting parameter. For a ball nose tool cutting parameter, we have to input step over value is as less than the 8 mm of ball nose. Then transition same, step shallow same, linking parameter same. And now we have to go in a stock. At stock, we click trim to stock. And now the next one is roughing tool. We have to select a roughing tool. We have to create what is the roughing tool diameter. What is the roughing tool diameter? It's 10 mm. And what is the corner radius of roughing tool diameter? It's 2 mm. Now click OK and regenerate. So guys, as you can see, our second one tool path, that is scale up rest passes, are already done. And we can easily create and we can easily remove that one rest material also by the help of scale up rest material. So let me show in a 2D form. So I wish you understand both of these operations. The number one operation is scale up high surface high speed, and the second one operation is scale up rest process. For more knowledge, be connected and updated. We are here for help you guys.